in your head.
Roly.
Kulto's hoard. I think you should give that gold a good home, sire. Without their females, the elven race would be wiped from the face of this land. No more elves. Ah, be still, my pretty heart.
We are the lost. Do not let this world forget the beauty of the elves.
Master, this place is collapsing! It's the gold or the elves? Let's hope they make it worth leaving all that lovely gold, sire. Now get yourself out of there! The minions have found a secluded gate, sire. I believe this is the Ruborian Desert. I can feel two more energy surges, my lord. There are more gates. One is enrapturing the elves of Evernight, so we can only hope it leads to something horrible. And either those dwarves have started blowing themselves up, or another gate has emerged in the Golden Hills. Salutations! Salutations! Forging is restful for the mind, sire. Helps clear your head for the evil deeds ahead. This is your armory, sire, where you can store your armor and weapons. little forging is restful for the mind, sire. Helps clear your head for the evil deeds ahead. This is your armory, sire, where you can store your armor and weapons. Always a pleasure to have you around, Lord, but don't you think you should be elsewhere? You know, doing your job.
Preventer of the floral print menace.
Yeah. The forest is starting to sing again. You have given our deaths meaning.
Another of those gates. Perhaps all that concentrated evil from those heroes is forcing something to the surface, like some kind of suffocating pustule.
I hear it's a new theatrical production about the glories of the elven race. May they do us justice, brother.
Don't seem to like the light. Oh, I know how they feel.
Everybody, elves.
My eyes cannot continue to watch this travesty.
Roots! And Overlord Greenhaze! Ah, I see we have a special guest in the back. Now, welcome to the Terror of Evernight Forest. I do hope you enjoy the show. Act 1, in which the elven race live peacefully deep in the Evernight Forest, protected by the unworthy deity, the Mother Goddess.
Oh, brother, how lucky we elves are to live in the bounteous green bosom of Evernight.
Aye, my friend, we are. Let us pray to the Mother Goddess.
For although she is a cold and uncaring harlot, undeserving of worship, she alone will listen to our woe, our sorrow, and our poetry.
Cold and uncaring harlot, eh? The writer of this play doesn't seem to like the Mother Goddess much. Or the elves, for that matter. I think I'm a fan already.
Act 2, in which the dwarves attack Evernight, crushing the elves into the ground of their precious forest.
Now that's entertainment!
Act 3, in which the Terror comes to Evernight Forest. Troll, where is it? Where's the Terror? I want the Terror!
Oh, what do you mean it's broken? Okay, back to Act One again, everyone. It's not like you lot don't need the practice.
Oh, Shane, just as it was getting good. Perhaps you should locate this terror of Evernight, sire. Help end things with a bang.
Act One, in which the elven race live peacefully deep in the Evernight Forest, protected by the unworthy deity, the Mother Goddess.
Oh, brother, how lucky we elves are to live in the bounteous green bosom of Evernight.
Aye, my friend, we are. Let us pray to the Mother Goddess.
For although she is a cold and uncaring harlot, undeserving of worship, she alone will listen to our woe, our sorrow, and our poetry.
Act Two, in which the dwarves attack Evernight, crushing the elves into the ground of their precious forest.
They are mocking us! Mocking us!
Ta-da! Still broken. Back to Act One.
Oh.
There's the Abyss Stone, sire. Oberon's roots are covering it.
I never said that. How can they call this art?
Pray to the Mother Goddess.
For although she is a cold and uncaring harlot, undeserving of worship, she alone will listen to our woe, our sorrow, and our retreat.
Act Two, in which the dwarves attack Evernight, crushing the elves into the ground of their precious forest. Forest, protected by the unworthy deity, the Mother Goddess.
Yeah.
Although she is a cold and uncaring harlot, undeserving of our worship, she alone will listen to our woe, our sorrow, and our poetry.
Act two, in which the dwarves...
It's Roly! That must be the... Terra! Oh, better find a way to reach it, my lord. Playing the dwarves get ready, sire. Ah, splendid work. Very moving. Could you give me an autograph, would you?
Act two, in which the dwarves attack Evernight, crushing the elves into the ground of their precious forest. Act one, in which the elven race live peacefully deep in the Evernight Forest, protected by their unworthy deity, the Mother Goddess.
I, my friend, we are. Let us pray to the Mother Goddess.
For although she is a cold and uncaring harlot, undeserving of worship, she alone will listen to our woe, our sorrow, and our poetry.
Act two, in which the dwarves attack Evernight Forest. Dwarves!
I think that...
Ah, there's the lighting cue. Right, act one again. Elven race live peacefully deep in the Evernight Forest, protected by the unworthy deity, the Mother Goddess.
Yeah.
Act One, in which the elven race live peacefully deep in the Evernight Forest, protected by the unworthy deity, the Mother Goddess.
Oh, brother, how lucky we elves are to live in the bounteous green bosom of Evernight.
Aye, my friend, we are. Let us pray to the Mother Goddess.
For although she is a cold and uncaring harlot, undeserving of worship, she alone will listen to our woe, our sorrow, and our poetry.
Act Two, in which the dwarves attack Evernight Forest. Dwarves! Dwarves! Prepare for Act One, you.
Without the terror, the play can't progress to the third act.
No autographs, please. I must have my rest. Bounteous green bosom of Evernight.
Aye, my friend, we are. Let us pray to the Mother Goddess.
For although she is a cold and uncaring harlot, undeserving of worship, she alone will listen to our woe, our sorrow, and our poetry. The play must go on, and on, and on, and on.
Stage, sire. It's where all the lovely, wonderful magic of the theater happens.
Live peacefully deep in the Evernight Forest, protected by their unworthy deity, the Mother Goddess.
I know that voice, that condescending tone. Don't worry, it'll come to me, sire.
Aye, my friend, we are. Let us pray to the Mother Goddess.
For, although she is a cold and uncaring harlot, undeserving of our worship, she alone will listen to our woe, our sorrow, and our poetry.
Starring role, if you can find a way to fix that thing.
Okay. Although she is a cold and uncaring harlot, undeserving of our worship, she alone will listen to our woe, our sorrow, and our poetry.
Act two, in which the dwarves attack Evernight, crushing the elves into the ground of their precious forest. Elven race live peacefully deep in the Evernight Forest, protected by the unworthy deity, the Mother Goddess.
Aye, my friend, we are. Let us pray to the Mother Goddess.
For, although she is a cold and uncaring harlot, undeserving of our worship, she alone will listen to our woe, our sorrow, and our poetry.
Act two, in which the dwarves attack Evernight, crushing the elves into the ground of their precious forest.
Your audience are waiting, Dark Master.
Back to Act One.
Taking position.